Georgia, a land of 4.6 million people in the Southern Caucasus, a former Soviet republic that proclaimed its independence in 1991 and went over to the market economy. An agrarian country where more than 50% of the workforce are still in the farming sector. This includes David Abinoidze. A grower aged 50, he produces onions, melons, cucumbers, and other vegetables in the Marnuli region, 1 hour by road from the capital, Tbilisi.
Now we're going to the wholesale market, where most of our produce is sold. People come from Tbilisi, Gori. They come 50, 60, even 300 kilometers to sell all their goods at this market.
The Tamarisi market, well known to the vegetable growers of the region, is also a meeting point for all communities.
Everyone comes here. Armenians, Azerbaijanis, Georgians, Russians. There are no differences, no quarrels. Everybody comes to sell what they grow or to buy. In fact, everybody comes to make money by trading.
And David welcomes this peaceful coexistence because things weren't always like that. The situation in the Southern Caucasus is now calm, but the region has seen a series of bloody conflicts since the beginning of the 90s. Starting with Georgia in 1991, severely shaken by two successive crises, when first South Ossetia and then Abkhazia seceded. In 2008, fighting flared up again in South Ossetia. This led to the intervention of Russian troops and the bombing of Georgian territory. On the other side of the border, beginning in 1991, Azerbaijan and Armenia fought a three-year war over the Nagorno-Karabakh region. Despite a ceasefire declared in 1994, relations between the two neighbors remain difficult, and a peaceful solution to the conflict has not yet been found. Gerrit Hogenboom knows this situation too well. An American researcher, he is supervising the Science for Peace and Security program for NATO. On this program, he works hand-in-hand with Tamaz Odilavadze and Konstantin Zyava of the Georgian State Agrarian University. For these scientists, this day is a bit special.
Today we have a very important meeting at the Georgian Water Management Institute. We'll meet with all our team members from Armenia, Azerbaijan and the USA. We would like to present the project results, those activities that carried out during the 3 years implementation period, and also the scientific achievements of this project.
The aim of the Science for Peace and Security program is to design, analyze, assess, and promote new agricultural irrigation techniques in Georgia, Armenia, and Azerbaijan in order to preserve the water resources of these three countries. Beyond the economic and ecological dimensions, it is also a matter of defusing possible future conflicts by directly tackling the causes.
Rivers don't really understand political boundaries, and in many cases, rivers will start in one country and then move into another country. So there are big issues about who gets to the water first and who uses it. So, I mean, there's a high likelihood that future wars will be fought over water and not over territory boundaries. So this particular project is to look at improvement of irrigation, and especially trying to introduce modern irrigation techniques such as drip irrigation.
The nature of the land may be different on either side of the frontiers, but Armenia, Azerbaijan and Georgia share certain geographical and hydrological characteristics. They are mountainous countries with dry climates, irrigated by the same rivers, in particular the Kura and its tributary, the Araxes. For Farda Imanov, an Azerbaijani specialist in this matter, it was more than obvious that his country should be involved in the program. It was a necessity.
In Azerbaijan, you see, 65 to 70% of the water resources are used just for agriculture. In the first place, because of natural conditions. The climate is dry, so there's not enough water. And then we use it badly, with old technologies, etc. In the end, it affects the harvest.
Same thing for the Armenians. Without rational use of the water resource, it's impossible to optimize the country's agricultural potential.
I am here today because, for Armenia, efficient use of water resources is a priority. Recent statistics show that today, nearly 100,000 hectares of usable land are neither irrigated nor cultivated for lack of water.
Givi Gavardashvili, director of the Georgian Water Management Institute, is also counting on the results of the Science for Peace and Security program.
Where the use of water resources is concerned, we have a problem in Georgia. The resources are concentrated in western Georgia, and there is very little in eastern Georgia. We have agreed with the Americans and Georgians in charge that all the positive solutions derived from this project will be applied in our three experimental centers, in Gori, Cernari, and Tbilisi.
The next morning, the group heads for Tamrizi to visit the agricultural producer partnering the program.
Here's our farmer, David Ebanoidze.
For 2 years, the farmer has made 6 of his 60 hectares available to the researchers. This was enough to carry out a battery of tests and assess the most suitable irrigation technique for the local climatic and geological conditions. An experiment in situ, which began by putting in the latest meteorological station.
Here, you can see the hydrometeorological station, which has been acquired with NATO financial support. This station measures the temperature and humidity down to a meter deep in the soil. It is the only station of its kind in the Southern Caucasus. It gives us every chance of working out what to do tomorrow. Should we irrigate or not?
For David, this technological aid meant a veritable revolution.
Up until now, I always did my watering in the traditional way. I opened the canal and used a shovel. That required a lot of water, about 15 times as much as with drip irrigation.
The traditional irrigation methods paid little heed to the water resource and could even prove counterproductive in the long term.
With this method, after watering the earth closes up and doesn't let the crop grow, it compresses it and the harvest is of poor quality. In the third place, you need a lot of chemicals to keep the plant healthy, more fungicide, much more.
The use of a drip irrigation system, combined with mulching, which suppresses weeds and keeps the moisture in the soil, rapidly convinced David with practical proof.
With this drip irrigation, you have not one, but 12 or 16 harvests.
The farmer is very happy to open his doors wide and show his colleagues, wherever they come from, the benefits of drip irrigation.
When the people come, they see things which are new and take them back home. Without politics, Armenians, Azerbaijanis, here we are all friends. We drink to each other. The Armenians and Azerbaijanis sit down side by side.
And for the remaining skeptics, David has an unanswerable argument, which is more sensual than scientific.
With these NATO cucumbers, I will make them a salad.
Здесь сейчас консолидируют, надо ли где...